So much for this, sir. Now, you shall see the other. You do remember all the circumstances?
Remember it, my lord.
Sir, in my heart, there was a kind of fighting that would not let me sleep. Methought I lay worse than the mutinous in the bilboes, rashly and praised be rashness for it. Let us know our indiscretion sometimes serves us well when our deep plots do pow, and that should teach us there's a divinity that shapes our ends, rough hew them how we will.
That is most certain.
Upon from my cabin, my sea gone scarfed about me in the dark, grouped I to find out them had my desire, fingered their packet and in fine withdrew to mine own room again. Make so bold my fears forgetting manners to unseal their grand commission, where I found Horatio, O royal knavery, an exact command, larded with many several sorts of reasons, importing Denmark's health and England's too, with ho, such bugs and goblins in my life, that on the supervise no leisure baited, no, not to stay on the grinding of the axe, my head should be struck off.
Is it possible?
Aye, here's the commission. Read it at more leisure.
So Guildenstern and Rosencrantz go to it.
Why, man, they did make love to this employment. They're not near my conscience. Their defeat does by their own insinuation grow. 'Tis dangerous when the baser nature comes between the pass and fell incensed points of mighty opposites.
And why, what a king is this?
Does it not think thee? Stand me upon now. He hath killed my king and whored my mother. Popped in between the election and my hopes. Thrown out his angle for my proper life. And with such cozenage, is it not perfect conscience to quit him with this arm? And is it not to be damned to let this canker of our nature come in further evil?
It must be shortly known to him from England. What is the issue of the business there?
It will be short. The interim's mine, and a man's life's no more than to save one. But I am very sorry, good Horatio, that to Laertes I forgot myself. Far by the image of my cause I see that poor treasure of his. I'll court his favors, but sure the bravery of his grief did put me into a towering passion.
Peace, who comes here? Welcome to Denmark, my lord.
I humbly thank you, sir.
Dost know this waterfly?
No, my good lord.
Thy state is more gracious, for 'tis a vice to know him. He hath much land and fertile. Let a beast be lord of beasts, and his crib shall stand at the king's mass. 'Tis a church, but as I say, spacious in the possession of dirt.
My lord, if you have a free moment, I have a message from his majesty.
I will receive it, sir, with all diligence of spirit.
My lord, his majesty wanted me to tell you that he has placed a large bet on you.
Sir, there's someone named Laertes who's recently come to the court. He's an absolute gentleman, totally outstanding in so many respects, very easy in society, and displaying all his excellent qualities. If I were to expose my true feelings about him, I'd have to say he's like a business card of the upper classes. He's that wonderful, you will find that he's a sum of what a perfect gentleman should be.
Sir, his definement suffers no perdition in you, though I know to divide him inventorily would deceive the arithmetic of memory. And yet, but you are neither, in respect of his quick sale. But in the verity of extolment, I take him to be a soul of great article. and his infusion of such dearth and rareness as to make him true diction of him. His semblable is his mirror, and who else would trace him? His umbrage? Nothing more.
I know you know something about how excellent Laertes is. Excellent in fencing. I mean, sir, his reputation in fencing is unrivaled.
What's his weapon?
The rapier and the dagger.
That's two of his weapons. But well...
The king has bet 6 Barbary horses, and he has prepared 6 French rapiers and daggers, with all their accessories. 3 of the carriages are very imaginatively designed, and they match the fencing accessories. The king, sir, has bet that in 12 rounds between you and Laertes, he won't beat you by more than 3 hits. You could get started immediately if you give me your answer.
But what if my answer is no?
I mean, if you agree to play against Laertes, sir.
Sir, I will walk here in the hall, if it pleases his majesty. 'Tis the breeding time of day with me. Let the foils be brought, the gentleman willing, and the king hold his purpose. I will win for him, and I can. If not, I'll gain nothing but my shame and the odd hits.
Shall I quote you in those exact words, sir?
To this effect, sir, after what flourishes, your nature will.
My services are at your command.
Yours, yours.
This lapwing runs away with a shell on his head.
He did not comply, sir, with this dog before he sucked it. Thus has he, and many more of the same bevy that I know the drossy ages dots on. Only got the tune of the time and outward habit of encounter, a kind of yeasty collection which carries them through and through the most fond and winnowed opinions, and do but blow them to their trial, and bubbles are out.
My lord, his majesty commended him to you by young Osric, who brings back to him that you attend him in the hall. He sends to know if your pleasure hold to play with Laertes, or that you'll take longer time.